I am very excited to have our next guest in the Genius Minds of Wellness series today. It is Annie Chamberlain from New Beginnings Massage and Holistic Care in Granby, Connecticut. Annie works with a whole variety of different therapeutic modalities, everything from massage and reflexology to meditation and yoga, and even Eastern therapies like Chinese herbal medicine and acupuncture. And she serves people who really need it. She works with disabled, with military, men and women who've come back from Iraq or coming out of prison, women who are coming out of abusive relationships. So she's really delivering the medicine where it's needed most. Annie, welcome to Genius Minds of Wellness. I'm really excited to have you on the show today.
Well, thank you, Robert. Thank you for inviting me.
How did you get interested in wellness and healing in the first place, Annie?
Well, I started many years ago when my children were little. I was like, all right, how can I get myself back in shape after having a baby? You know, every woman wants to know that. So I started programs so I could get back in shape. From there, it just grew. And then I had an incident that happened to me in 1995 that literally changed my life. And a lot of physicians were telling me I wasn't going to be able to do all the things I did before because of my injuries, and I didn't believe them. So I went to massage therapists, acupuncturists, and reflexologists, Reiki people. And guess what? I healed myself. And from then, that day, I said, you know something? I have to do this. So I got healed. Now I need to share this with other people. And so New Beginnings was born.
Self-healing is something you have to experience yourself.
Yeah, that's for sure. And it's so wonderful because now when you speak to someone, you have history. So you can be more empathetic with them.
You work with a wide variety of therapeutic modalities. When a person comes to you looking for a change in their life, how do you choose what to offer them?
That's a really good question because what I do is different than most any other place around. And that is I am like the triage nurse. So if you go to a hospital, someone meets you, they ask you questions, and they decide where you're going to go. And that's exactly what I do. I sit you down. I ask you a series of questions. Sometimes I'll do a Reiki session on you or a foot reflexology session. And then I'll know who should you see. And we have the most amazing healers here. Because we work with the medical community, a lot of our people that work for me here are RNs, and they're going into holistic medicine. So what we do as massage therapists or Reiki therapists or our counselors is we all work together as a team. So after I figure out where you belong and who's the best fit for you, you go to that person, and from there, they'll take care of you. And if they think you need to see someone else after they've seen you, we just keep doing that, and we're just a big loving family. So our whole thing, honestly, is we're going to make you the best you can be. We're going to literally love you back to optimum health. That's what our job is.
You've chosen to work with types of people who come from situations where they're really challenged, disabled, people coming out of prison or out of military situations. Mm-hmm. Why did you make that choice? Why not take the easy road?
We did when we started 17 years ago. We were doing, you know, what everybody else does. At that time, it was New Beginnings Fitness and Beauty. We were a gym and a regular spa kind of thing. Then just through my walk of faith, my faith walk brought me to here. And I got to meet people and I saw the need. So I just stopped what I was doing, regrouped, started over, and people just kept coming to us. And so we're just really good listeners, and we were listening to where our community needed us. So we just stopped where all the money was and started this. This has been a gift to us. You know, the more we give to these people, the more we get.
Let's take your military clients as an example. How do they find out about you? Are they receptive and open to your holistic approach?
Oh, my goodness. Well, first of all, one of our massage therapists, her husband, just came back from, I think it was Iraq. You know, we know up close and personal what it was like for her while he was gone. And so because of that, you know, we've been reaching out to people like her who are left behind. People forget about the families. We want to support those families. And then when the guys come back, we want them to know that they have a safe place. Yes, they love us because we're here to do whatever they need. We don't say, okay, tell us what happened over there. If you want to tell us, you tell us. If you don't, you don't have to. We just want to put our hands on you and love you. If whatever happens after that, that's terrific. And that's how we got into that, is because one of our therapists is in the military, her husband.
Which types of treatments or therapies do you find you end up using the most often?
Foot reflexology is really big here. foot reflexology and Reiki, massage therapy, auricular ear therapy, which is a form of acupuncture. Those are very big. All the yoga breathing techniques, because we don't just do regular yoga. It is yoga for couples, yoga for children, yoga for individuals to help with stress and relaxation. In our area, there's yoga studios everywhere, mm-hmm. everywhere. What we do is different because we're very individualized, and one of our yoga instructors, this young woman that we'll be bringing on board, the reason I liked her, she also has her master's in counseling. So she uses this technique to help people to totally release stress and anxiety. And the other instructor is the same thing. It's like, so we're going to breathe into these muscles, and when we release, this is what's going to happen to you. This is a physiological thing that happens in your body. So we explain that. So where the other places are just doing meditation and the movements, we explain what's happening while you are doing this. And people love it. They're like, oh, I didn't know my muscles were doing that. And then, like, we'll do a blood pressure before and a blood pressure after. No one else does that. We take breaks and take a pulse. Very scientific, because people want us to prove to them all the time, how does this work? How do I know it's working? And we say, well, we will show you.
My introduction to the whole world of wellness and healing was yoga. And I was astonished. It was a revelation to me that it was possible to just slow down and feel what the muscles are doing.
Yeah, isn't it amazing? Yoga, it's whatever you need it to be. So we may not be doing the yoga from, you know, where you bow and you do all these things. We're doing yoga as any kind of meditative movement where you can release anxiety and calm your mind.
Do you teach traditional meditation as well?
Yes, we do teach meditation. We do the quieting of the mind meditation. So again, different than what everybody in our area does. What's different about us is that we are a God-based business. I have my definition of what that means, and you might have your definition of what that means. So we meditate on that, and the creator, the person who created you, what does that mean to you? How do you connect? And that's what we work through.
You're actually taking people who've come from very hard situations, and you're teaching them how to soften and how to let go of the stress and the pain that they're holding on to.
Yeah, that's exactly what we're doing. It doesn't do any good to hold on to those things. It makes you sicker. That sickness loves that. When you have a pure mind and heart, you can let the healing begin. But when you're holding on to anxiety, that's how your cells go crazy. Our biggest gift to people is we validate where you are and where you've been. But we want you to step over that threshold. We want you to open the new door.
You cooperate with the medical community as well quite a bit. How does that go? There's usually quite a gap between the medical community and the holistic health community.
Yeah, some of the doctors, they call us witches. I just like, okay. But we are very fortunate because I get to go and speak to them because we have nurses here. That makes it credible. So we are listened to. And so now we have endocrinologists who work with us. We have oncologists who work with us. We have two surgeons who work with us. We have, I used to, you know, with the doula, so I helped deliver babies and all. So I have a lot of the OBGYN people. It's just, it's been wonderful to see them becoming a little softer and understanding that we're not trying to take away their clientele, so to speak, but we want to work with them. I was working on someone's feet and doing Reiki on her, and I noticed something wasn't right. Her energy was off, and it's hard for people to understand this unless they've experienced it. But I could feel it. I could feel it in the point. There was a blockage. And I said to her, I want you to go to your doctor. This is what I'm feeling. Well, come to find out, unfortunately, she had cancer. And they weren't, for a long time, they didn't listen to me because they didn't believe me. And we had to push it and push it and push it. And the cancer was hidden behind the uterine wall. So they're like, oh, how did you know that? And I can't really explain how I know it. I just do. And so, you know what? When things like that happen, and that happens a lot in this practice, they listen to us because they don't get it. But they're like, all right, whatever. And it's been beautiful. And this is what we say to people. Why do you just do what these people tell you to do? You know, honestly, be your own advocate. And if you don't like your doctor, fire him. If you don't like me, fire me. But don't just take what we say for face value. Go out there and be responsible.
But isn't that the reason why the medical community and the wellness holistic community are so often at odds against each other? That kind of empowerment that you're talking about has got to be very uncomfortable for doctors.
Yeah, they don't like it when I say things like that. And I said, you know what? If I don't like you, I'm firing you.
That's got to be bad news for a medical doctor who's used to speaking from a position of unquestionable authority.
Yeah, well, oh well. I mean, you know, we have to start taking charge of our own bodies. We cannot keep saying what the doctor said. Well, you also did what he said without even questioning, so shame on you as well. No matter where you are in life, I don't care if you're the healing person or if you're the patient, you need to work together. And one can't be putting all the blame and all the power into the other. It is a team.
That's right. How long did it take you to get comfortable with your business financially and emotionally so that you weren't awake all night worrying about how are you going to pay the rent next month?
Okay, well, here's something interesting about me. It doesn't happen with a lot of people. I believe really that God put me in this place, so he's the CEO of my company. I honestly have no worries. I just do what I'm supposed to do and believe it's going to happen. But when I first started, I had to do something that's hard for human beings to do. I had to delegate. I had to be able to say, I don't know how to do it. Would you help me? And what I see, especially with our youth, they don't want you to help them because they think they have all the answers.
Was that the turning point for your business when you figured out how and what to delegate?
Yeah, I mean, it just, you know, once you realize you don't know all the answers and you need help, and you just let it go, there's no worry because you have to trust, like everyone I brought in my business, I trusted them to do what I hired them to do. Didn't micromanage them, just let them do what they have to do. If they ask questions, they'll come to me. And then when I have questions, I go to someone who knows the answer. I remember telling my husband, oh, by the way, I'm going to rent that building over there, and I'm going to do this building, this whole thing. And he just laughed at me and said, there's no way you're going to be able to do that. And I was like, okie dokie. And sat down, made up a business plan, went to a bank, sold that bank on that business plan. They gave me money. I went in. I started, and I went to all, right from that day, got these amazing people to help me. And then from there, I started to help. So whatever they taught me, I would teach somebody else. And it's just been going like that ever since.
What are the biggest challenges for your business in sales and marketing?
I think that's the biggest thing for all business, and that is, first of all, where do you spend your money? You better know where your money should go. You better know what your target market is. So sit down and figure out who are you marketing to. And then where should that money go? What's the best place to get to those people? Then after you do that, you need to be a good listener. And that means listen to what the community is saying. Look at the other businesses that are like yours. Where do they succeed and where are they failing? Use that to make yourself great. So, for example, you know, when you start out, you do a whole bunch of different marketing because you don't know. So then you have to keep track. So every time someone calls us, I ask them how they heard about us. And I keep a record of that. Mm-hmm. I know, okay, this is a good place to advertise. For our business, the best thing is word of mouth and all the things we do that way. But when you get started, there is no word of mouth. So you just kind of have to go do it. And I think small town papers, you know, go through your local chamber of commerce. You know, start small and then work your way up. And then you'll be able to find out which works, which doesn't work, what things you should do, and what things you should stay away from.
What's your bread and butter?
Word of mouth. But because we're affiliated with so many people, because hospital people know us, military knows us, everybody knows us, so we're lucky because we get a lot of referrals because of that. But we've been on TV, we've been on the radio, we do a lot of things like that. We go out, we speak, I do a lot of public speaking. You know, you just have to get out there. People have to know you. And the biggest thing is, like for us, people know our logo because we're, you know, they can see the logo and not even know, see the name and know it's us. That's awesome. It's fabulous. So when you're starting a business, you better find a really awesome logo, stay with it, and market your logo.
Do you read any trade magazines to stay current?
I do not read a lot of those kinds of things. I go by what I, in my immediate little world, my community that I'm serving, and I read what I think I need to know for these people. Now, if I was going to be going somewhere outside of here, yes, I would research that too. But I also know that I can't be everything to all people, so I'm very cautious to stay very connected to where I am and who I am.
Is there anything else you would like to cover?
If anyone in the Hartford area in Connecticut is listening, if you're in the military or you're an EMS, you know, please call us, and we always give a discount to those people no matter what. No matter what special we're running, you always have some special place in our heart, and we're going to take care of you. If you know somebody who just needs to be validated, who needs to be have a hands-on approach to healing, mind, body, or spirit, again, send them our way.
If our listeners would like to get in touch with you or just learn more about what you do, how can they reach you?
I guess the best way might be to go to that little website, and that would be NewBeginningsHolisticCare.com.
NewBeginningsHolisticCare.com. All one word. No punctuation, no spaces.
Yeah, all one word.
Do you have a phone number as well?
Someone wanted to speak to me directly or needed to speak to one of our amazing therapists. It's area code 860-653-0196.
Thank you so much for spending this time with me and sharing your stories and your insights.